Darren Millard, Doug McLean, and Gordy Stellick. Here's David Backus of the Boston Bruins. Thanks for joining us. Appreciate you jumping on. You guys, did you turn the team around, or what really turned the tide to go on this massive run? Because I'm thinking it might be you.
Well, thanks for having me, first of all. I don't know that it's me, but I think there was a few events that happened all at the same time where we got a lot of our healthy bodies back in the lineup after, other guys had plugged holes while we were out with different ailments, and that really created a mindset within the guys that was blue collar, that was simplifying the game, and it was making other teams come 200 feet and capitalizing when you have your opportunities. And then you add a skill element back in there, not for me, but from other guys that were on the lineup, and all of a sudden your conversion rate goes up and the crooked numbers start coming on the board, and it's a lot easier to win when you're scoring a bunch of goals.
So, David, I've got to tell you, I've become a Bruins fan big time. I've hardly missed a game, to be quite honest. So, we're always saying the physicalness is not where it should be in the game and all this. And then I watch you guys play from the number one line to the fourth line, and it's constant pursuit. It's constant pressure. Fun to watch from the top of the lineup to the bottom of the lineup.
Yeah, and that's part of what Bruce is brought in as a coach, where he wants us playing with pace and on our toes and being able to skate with other teams. But when we arrive at puck battles, we need to be, accountable to yourself and to your teammates that you're going to get a job done when you're there. And playing for each other gives you a little bit more incentive and makes you dig a little bit deeper into those battles. And you come out with more pucks, you get more chances to the net, you're going to score more goals. And I think that it starts to wear on teams as the game goes on. And even if we're up 2-1, other teams are pressing, we're in good spots, and we've been able to score in bunches, especially late in games when they do have to press in order to try to get one.
The goaltender controversy call, interference call or not last night, did your current teammates see it different than your ex-teammates?
yes, through each bias lens that we looked through, I think there were differing opinions. And with all of them that happen throughout the league on a nightly basis, this is becoming a running joke, I think, at some point. I don't know what the solution is necessarily. And when they go your favor, you love it. And when they go against you, you wonder what the heck's going on, and you try to get new definitions of the rule all the time. But the definition or the help that I was given is that if it's in the blue paint, the goaltender is going to get the benefit of the doubt more often than not. And if it's outside of the blue paint, then that's the player's area, and it's going to be the player getting the benefit of the doubt. And for the majority of them, if you look at it that way, that's kind of the way it's fallen. But there's the anomaly or the special examination of the rule that you just kind of go, I'm not sure. And, hopefully we'll get that back, or it'll balance itself out in the end.
Bruins veteran David Backus with us on Hockey Central at noon with Darren Millard, Gord Stellick, and Doug McLean. So when you saw that play last night, were you confident the goal would stand based on the visual?
Once they challenged it, and then I saw the replay with maybe a slide tackle, maybe a box out of the goalie, and then a tap in on the other side, I was not real certain that we were going to have a 1-0 lead after they were done reviewing it. But that being said, you watch it a couple other times, and I don't know if Jake Allen tries to cross-check a guy or leans into him trying to get back to that weak side of the net, there's more effort. And that was kind of the explanation they gave, that he didn't think he was able to get back there regardless and doesn't make much of an effort to. But
and he didn't argue right away.
I'm not.
He just took for granted it was going to be goalie interference.
Playing it out, I mean, all that stuff kind of, it does play a role in it. But, again, I think they all even themselves out at the end, and we're going to not complain about that 1-0 lead that we had at that point in the game.
So, David, you've been well known as a leader on a team and a 200-foot player your whole career. What's it like now when you come to a new team and you see the way Bergeron plays night after night in every zone, in every situation? I mean, what does that do for yourself as a veteran and for the youngsters on this team?
You know, he's a really special player, and somebody that from afar you get to see him play and you're like, all right, he does some good stuff out there. But when you see him on a daily basis and you see the checking matchups he gets into, the offense that he provides, the leadership he provides, the ability to play through injury, play through sickness, to create culture, and just an all-around awesome guy, great guy in the room, great teammate, great friend. All of a sudden you go, there is a reason that he's been getting so many accolades and he wins that dang Selke Award every year, even though I keep reminding him that maybe 2011, he got lucky on that one. I don't know. But he's an all-around great human, and including a hockey player, and I can't say enough good things about him. He scores timely goals. Him and Marshy's chemistry when they're out there together is like something I've never seen. And, you know, he's a huge reason why we've had a ton of success this year and why the Bruins have had so much success in his tenure here.